wondered why steak from the butcher tastes so different from what you eat in restaurants, I'm here to interview Ibrahim of Butcher Boutique in Cathedral Town of Markham, looking to promote small business owners across Markham and share their story. Let's go take a look. Ibrahim, thank you so much for doing this.
Pleasure.
Well, you know, it's really nice because I was like, our office is right across the street from you. And I know that the team comes in to get their goodies from here. So I'm like, why not come and speak with you and hear a little bit more about the story of Butcher Boutique?
Well, Butcher Boutique actually started because of you.
Oh.
Yeah. So I used your services before. And by coincidence, saw this place, and that's where I thought of the idea of getting a store and start retailing the meat that I love cooking so much.
I love that. Well, yeah. So tell me, let's go a little pre-Butcher Boutique. What were you doing before all of this?
So right before here, I was the corporate chef for Ruth Chris Steakhouse.
And who has not heard of that?
It's pretty famous. I ran their Toronto operation and I assisted in some of their US operations. And then from there, I found my passion for meat and the love of meat. A lot of my friends always wondered why the meat tastes so different at the restaurant than it does at home. Not realizing that restaurants get a different grade of meat, different quality of meat. There's no additives, there's no preservers, there's nothing like that. I wanted to make that available.
How long were you a corporate chef? Like how many years was that?
I've actually been a chef for 29 years.
Wow.
I owned some restaurants in Europe before, came here, started some restaurants again. And when I sold my business, I was like, okay, I'm out of the restaurant business.
Yeah.
I was back into it after 3 months. And that's how long it took for me to retire from the restaurant business. Never left. You can never leave the restaurant business. And hopefully this will lead into another restaurant business.
That is amazing. Yeah, and you know what? It's like if you love what you do, then it's not really work.
And you do what you love.
Right? There you go. And I take it, I imagine you've seen the movie Chef.
Probably every cooking movie you can ever imagine.
Yeah.
You learn from them. You learn from TV. You watch cooking shows. You watch everything. And you get ideas. You get inspired.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So the idea formulated when you were sitting around with friends.
We were sitting around with friends, and those friends are actually my current partners. There's four of us, one of which was the GM and the regional manager for Ruth Chris. Myself, we've worked together for 7 years. We developed a very strong friendship. And from there, we talked about starting this business. The third person is actually one of my best friends, who's my next door neighbor, Wilfred. And he's a wine expert. Wine and meat, they go hand in hand. And the fourth person is actually the landlord of this place, the guy who owns this place. When he, after he rented it to me, saw what we sell, tried the meat, he begged. He's like,
I
need to be part of this. This is life-changing.
Yeah.
And he became part of it. And now he moved to New Market. He runs the New Market location. Mike is currently at the Bridal Trail location. And Wilfred is right here, hiding in the back.
That is amazing. Yeah. So three locations and you opened them all in the span of?
3 months.
3 months?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's crazy. So and we're going all in.
So what are the plans from here?
From here, we expand. It's, you know, we're trying to keep it a tight circle. And a tight circle grows, hopefully with your help. I'll be able to grow it. You have
of
to
course.
Find me locations, you know, to extend our arm a little bit. So we're thinking Vaughan, Richmond Hill, and then we go up west and we start sharing all this love, all this meat with everybody.
In terms of supply, where are you getting this amazing quality meat from? And what would make you different from
everybody
other butchers
else?
That are out there?
Very good question. The first thing is that one, our product is all aged to specification. Being a chef, I request a special amount of days for aging the meat, a special process for aging the meat. Everything has to be vacuum packed. Everything is cut in the morning, delivered the same day, pretty much sold the same day or the day after.
Right.
All our product comes directly from Japan, Australia, US. We specialize in Wagyus, but we carry everything from USDA Prime, Canadian Prime, to even our own recipe for deli, our own spices. We do everything from scratch.
Wow.
Yeah. All right. So I'll take you to a quick journey. Wagyu started in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
We import many, many different regions from Japan, from Snow Age to Kobe Wagyu. Japanese Wagyu is the most pure form of Wagyu. It is the pure breed. From there, you move to Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Australia is the only other country where Japanese farmers were allowed to immigrate and actually farm their cows,
Wagyu. Okay.
So it is the closest thing to pure and my own favorite. From Australia, you go to US. US started breeding Wagyu, which is not a pure breed because it's a blend of the Wagyu cow and the Black Angus cow together.
Right.
And then they started breeding it around 20 years ago. So the breed itself is getting purer and purer and purer, but it's not just there yet. Canada have actually recently started breeding Wagyu in Alberta, and it's just getting there. But for now, it tastes like you're eating a USDA prime steak. It's not not just there yet.
Yeah.
So that's what we're trying to bring to the market without charging the $300, $400 a pound tag that this meat comes with. We actually take the product and try to sell it at pretty much at cost. But that attracts the client that buys everything else. And that's how we make our money. We make it out of the basic things, not so much out of the Wagyus.
Now, price point-wise, would they all be similarly priced?
They're actually very differently priced. Mm-hmm. So if you go to Japan, it costs twice as much as Australia.
Okay.
Australia costs us twice as much as US.
Wow.
Yeah. But the US, for Wagyu, it only costs a little bit more than the USDA Prime.
Right.
So it's not so much more expensive per pound. It's $10 difference to buy a Wagyu steak.
Right.
And still get the flavor of Wagyu, get that feed that the cow gets. It's all about the feed. It's what the cow eats. That's what makes it so unique.
Right.
They don't just get the regular grass or the regular corn. They actually eat sweet potato. They eat grains. They eat barley. They eat so much in their feed that makes them so unique. The flavor is so rich and has so much to offer.
No, of course. And now you offer more than steak. Here.
Absolutely. Organic chicken. It's air-chilled, free-run chicken, Canadian product. We offer Australian lamb. We offer our own marinated products like marinated chicken. We offer USDA Prime, Canadian Prime, lambs. We pretty much offer everything that you can imagine that has to do anything to do with meat. We even have Berkshire pork. So it's pretty much a whole meat story.
Now, people like me who don't like to get up and go anywhere, do you have a delivery option?
Yes, you can actually go online to thebutcherboutique.ca and you can place your order. You get your delivery right at home. And you can come pick it up. It's a choice of yours.
Beautiful. And delivery areas?
Right now, we're trying to cover pretty much the whole northeast side of the city.
Okay.
So anywhere from Scarborough, North York, Markham, Richmond Hill. You can go up to Aurora, Newmarket, Keswick.
So and the plan is to potentially
expand and hopefully go more south into the downtown core. And more west into Mississauga, Oakville, that area. And then we've covered Toronto.
And then you've covered Toronto.
Yep.
That is absolutely amazing.
We see where the journey takes us from there.
Yeah, absolutely. So now, if you were to give a couple of words of advice or wisdom to somebody that's kind of thinking about going it on their own, whether this business or any other business, what would you say? What's made this happen for you?
Go for it. All I can say is trust your gut. Do what you love. That's the main thing. For us, we love to meet people.
Yeah.
And we spell meet with M-E-A-T.
Yeah. I love it. Well, you know, it's like our business, we say it all the time. We're not in a real estate or a house business. We're in a people business.
Yes.
And I think most businesses are people businesses.
People come here not just to buy a steak. They ask us, how do you cook the steak? What's the best way to cook the steak? We teach them. It's a journey. We're trying to create a big family of Wagyu and a family of cooking. It's a new cult of beautiful food. That's what we're here for.
I love it. It's creating that, it's educating, creating the awareness and the growth. Beautiful. And on a last note, what is a fun fact or an interesting fact that you might want to share either about yourself or about the business?
Come buy some meat and invite me over to cook it, as long as you have some wine for me.
Oh, now listen, we might take you up on that offer.
Done.
Okay.
I will not turn it down.
Beautiful. So now just share with us how can people find you? What are your social media handles?
You can find us on Instagram. You can find us on Facebook. Go to the website. As I said, thebutcherboutique.ca. Tag us along, show us what you bought, show us how you cooked it. Let us show you how we cook it and compare.
Awesome.
Great.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
If you enjoyed watching this video and you would like to watch more interesting videos about businesses in Markham, please do like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on social media. Your leading real estate team across Markham and the GTA, Team Rajpal.